Hi, today I'm going to do a second video on the TV tuner after selling for 1.5 months. I'm also a user of my own product, so this is currently I'm running this unit for about 3 months. So very confident that this thing is selling very good. So I'd like to reinforce some of the extra points that I forgot to intro on the first video. So currently the unit is running in my Pioneer 4350, as you can see. I mute the sound so for my video recording purposes. So let me just briefly go through with you all some of the parts and accessories that comes with it. Okay, this is the first and foremost, this is the remote control. So remote control, you have the on off function, the change channel function plus minus and the volume, electronic program guide, subtitles if there's any in the digital signal, some menu functions, exit, audio function, and also not forgetting the electronic program guide. So next is the infrared sensor that you can see is for my remote control to interact with, and also the antenna. The antenna is supposed to be an indoor unit and not to be mounted in the bumper unit, which is some customer told me that their installer told them to. So apparently not, because there are some negative experiences that my consumer they listen. Because of the installer's expertise, but given the benefit of doubt, and when they install, right, after they watch for about 10 minutes, then the reception was very bad. So apparently, I think the antenna cable dropped somewhere, and after that, it was damaged. So it's not very expensive, but it's also not very cheap for the antenna cable. It costs about 25. And apparently, my unit is installed inside the TVBT2 unit is installed inside my head unit inside. So next time around, I will just take a shot, then you can just feel inside. But today, let me just briefly go through the basic functions of my unit. Okay, right now I'm looking at the channel 8 HD channel. So let me just let you see if there's any HD logo. As you can see, there's the HD logo. Currently my location is I'm at the Ang Mo Kio multi-story car park that is opposite the Ang Mo Kio hub. So I can see the reception is very good, because I think the area has implemented the DVB-T2 signals. If you follow my Carousell page, right, on this product, I also uploaded the map of the roll and of the sequence of rolling out of DVB-T2 by MediaCorp. This is not within my control, but apparently some of the areas like Tuas along the expressway is still not very good, and hopefully by last quarter of 2015 is getting better. Apparently it's very stable, you can see. Let me just on the sound so you can see the volume. So then let me just show you the other function. So let me just go to the program, the channel. So right now I'm channel 8, so I can go channel 5. I also don't know what is this show about. So yeah, my coffee tastes good, not like shit. Just kidding. Let me just briefly go through some of the functions. This is the DVB-T2 unit. It comes with a USB function on the unit itself, and also the SD card function, but currently I don't use it because I have the Pioneer 4350. As you can see, I can use my own unit's SD card and also my USB function somewhere, so I don't need it at the moment. Let me just introduce to you some of the function on the remote control. On the remote control, you can just plus minus the sign, you can see. I just press on the channel plus, I go to the next channel, channel 5, Vasantam. SD. Okay, the unit is also capable to display the traditional TV signals, but apparently it's not very stable, it's not very good. You're not able to surround, you're not be able to get some of the good quality sound and also images. The images will flicker on the SD channel. So let me just briefly show you. See, you can see all these are SD and not HD. HD are those that are very stable, very clear. Okay, currently my unit is running on the NTSC AV cables and not HDMI, so you can see it's very clear on the 7-inch. So this is Jay Chow and some, I think this is the Green Lantern, the show. Yeah, you can see some flickering. Yeah, despite me being at a multi-story car, I can still see all this. So you can see it's really working. This is CNA. Yeah. Okay, let me just go to channel 8. Let me, because I love that channel. Okay, this is the soccer show. Okay, let me just briefly go through some of the functions on the remote control. You can use the mute function. Mute function on again. Then these are some of the channels that you can play around. Okay, let me just go to the electronic program guide EPG. So you are able to see some of the electronic program guide, what are the show, and some of the description of the show later on. Then let me just go to, let me see, information. So you can, on the information page, you can see the frequency, how the signal that you're receiving, what the quality is like, how, what is the bandwidth and the frequency that you're receiving for this particular channel. Let me just exit it. Then, if you press the information, hold on, just a minute, sorry, not the information. Go to the audio, you're able to select the different kind of audio. It's very significant if you're using in-car. If you have already improved the normal speakers to the component speakers, then this will be playing a very big part. Particularly for the channel 5. Channel 5 will have the surround sound like you can see on the third one that is currently being selected. Yeah, so we can see all this. Wait, okay. For the menu wise, let's say you press the menu, right? The one menu, the last row, second from the left, you are able to see the search, the configuration, and the media menu. For the search function, it is very important for those who are currently using. For Singapore, when you're in Singapore, right, you want to receive all the TVB T2 signals, right? Best is you switch the country to Thailand. Hold on, just let me select so we can search to Thailand. And then you press on, you select the auto search and press enter on the remote control. Where's the enter? Yeah. Then you will do an auto search for everything. It will take for the searching wise, it will take about less than 3 minutes if you are in areas with very good reception. Yeah. Then it will show all the HD and the SD channels out. So let me just exit thing. Then for the configuration menu, you can select the pictures, the way it is being displayed. The best for me, currently I'm using 16:9 widescreen, 1080 resolution, NTSC format. And language is English, OSD, on screen display. That means English. And let me see. For the media, you can select the type that you want to use, like, oh, sorry. And like the music, photos, video, all this, but provided you insert in the USB devices. If you are unable to access the box when it is installed behind the unit, the best is you get a female and a male NTSC USB extension cable. Then you can extend it to somewhere behind where it is accessible for you to insert your thumb drive. That's it. I think it is very straightforward unit. You can see the show while driving. Because currently, every day when I drive from Sengkang Fernvale to Tuas South Avenue 9, this is very useful for me. Some of the past experience from my customers is that when driving along Sengkang and the Punggol, along the expressway, there's no, or the area itself, not just the expressway, the area is not very stable. It's because the TVBT2 signals, according to the roll-up map, it is from the third quarter 2015 to the 2016 onwards. So let's hope for the best. Some other areas like the expressway from the northern to the western, right, like the SLE, BKE, TPE, all these are quite acceptable in a way. It's still jams sometimes, but still okay when you go towards the Tampines area, which is it is being the signals are being overlapped by some other areas where it has been rolled out for the DVB-T2 signals. Other than that, for the southern areas, all are quite okay, acceptable. CT is okay, TIE is also okay, but just the northern itself lah. Let's hope for the best, and if there's any more updates, I'll just get back to you all. Okay, thanks, bye!